अस्सलामु अलैकुम। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ अबाउट सरफेस केमिस्ट्री फॉर सेमेस्टर 6। द टॉपिक इज़ लैंगमुयर्स एडसॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म। दिस आइसोथर्म वॉज प्रपोज बाई एरविन लैंगमुयर in 1916, and in 1932 this scientist was awarded Nobel Prize for his work in surface chemistry. This model relates the amount of gas adsorbed per unit quantity of adsorbent, unit amount of adsorbent, and the pressure of gas at constant temperature. That is under isothermal conditions. This isotherm gives a relationship between the amount of gas adsorbed per unit quantity of unit amount of adsorbent and the pressure of gas above the adsorbent. The basic concept of the theory is that if we have a solid surface, it is a solid which is called adsorbent, and we have this adsorbent present in a gas sample, and the gas molecules are colliding with the surface, then two processes may occur. First process is the adsorption process, during which the gas molecules get adsorbed onto the surface, stick to the surface of solid, and the second process is the reverse process, which is known as the desorption process. Thus, the adsorption and desorption processes occur side by side, and it leads to a dynamic equilibrium at a given temperature and pressure. Thus, a dynamic equilibrium is established between adsorption and desorption processes. The basic assumptions of this isotherm are, first assumption is that the surface of a solid is homogeneous. First, the adsorbent has a homogeneous surface. Second, each solid has a definite number of sites on which adsorption takes place, and these sites are known as adsorption sites. Second, each solid surface has a fixed number of adsorption sites, onto which the adsorption can occur. Each adsorption site is an equally energetically favorable for adsorption. Energetically favorable for adsorption. That is, the energy of adsorption is same for each adsorption site. The fourth assumption is that each adsorption site can adsorb only one molecule. Thus, the adsorption is monolayer thick. And the fifth assumption is that the molecules which are adsorbed on neighboring sites do not interact with each other. There is no interaction between molecules of the gas or adsorbate which are adsorbed on neighboring sites. The molecules on the neighboring sites do not interact with each other. So these are the basic assumptions of Langmuir's adsorption isotherm. The first assumption is that each adsorbent or solid surface has a homogeneous surface. Second, each solid surface has a fixed number of adsorption sites onto which the adsorption can take place. Third, each adsorption site is equally energetically favorable for adsorption. That is, the energy of adsorption always remains same for each site. Fourth, each adsorption site can hold only one molecule. Therefore, the adsorption is only single layer thick or monolayer thick. And fifth, no interaction takes place between the molecules which have been adsorbed on neighboring adsorption sites. Now we come to mathematical calculations for Langmuir's adsorption equation or Langmuir's adsorption isotherm. Mathematical derivation. Let us suppose we have a solid whose surface area is a solid surface, and there is a gas present above the solid surface. Let us suppose that the total solid surface, your surface area, is unity. It has unit surface area. Our surface area in this case is 1 square meter. Or 1. Now the gas molecules strike with the surface, adsorption and desorption take place, and we suppose that out of the total unit surface area, the covered area is theta. Let us suppose it is the covered area, the area which is covered by gas molecules is theta. The covered area, total surface area, is 1 square meter. The covered area is theta. Then the naked area, total area, is 1. Covered area is theta. Therefore, the naked area will be 1 minus theta. Naked area, the area which has not been occupied by the gas molecules, is given by 1 minus theta. Now we have already discussed that adsorption takes place, but at the same time some of the molecules also undergo desorption process, and a point is reached when the rate of adsorption becomes equal to the rate of desorption. At equilibrium state, the rate of adsorption is equal to rate of desorption. Equation number 1, at a given temperature. Now the rate of desorption is proportional to the covered area. Greater the number of gas molecules present adsorbed on the surface, there are greater chances for these molecules to get desorbed. Therefore, the rate of desorption is proportional to covered area. Or we can write Rd, rate of desorption, is proportional to theta. where theta is the covered area. Theta is the covered area. To change the sign of proportionality into sign of equality, we use a constant and we write Rd is equal to Kd into theta, where Kd is the rate constant for the desorption process. Let us suppose it is equation number 2. Kd is the rate constant for the desorption process. Constant for desorption process. The rate of adsorption is proportional to the product of naked area and the pressure of gas above the adsorbent. Rate of adsorption, RAD, rate of adsorption is proportional to the product of naked area, which is 1 minus theta, and the pressure of gas above the adsorbent is equal to the product of naked area multiplied by P. Rate of adsorption is directly proportional to the naked area of the solid as well as the pressure of gas above the adsorbent surface. To change proportionality into equality, we again use a proportionality constant and we get R adsorption, rate of adsorption is equal to K adsorption 1 minus theta into P. Equation number 3, where K adsorption is the rate constant for the adsorption process. It is the rate constant for adsorption process. The rate constants Kd and K, rate constant of desorption and adsorption, they depend upon the nature of gas, the nature of solid and temperature. Now we know that at equilibrium the rate of adsorption becomes equal to rate of desorption. Putting the values of rate of adsorption from equation 3 and rate of desorption equation number 2 into equation 1, we get, putting values of both the rates into equation number 1, we have the equilibrium condition. Rate of adsorption is equal to K AD 1 minus theta into P is equal to KD. It is the rate of Kd theta. Opening the bracket, we have Kad into P minus Kad theta into P is equal to Kd theta. Or we can write Kad P is equal to Kd theta plus Kad theta into P. Taking theta constant, we have theta is equal to Kd plus Kad into P is equal to Kad into P. Theta is equal to K, rate constant for adsorption into P, divided by Kd into K plus Kad into P, equation number 4. Thus we have the equation for theta, which is theta is equal to Kad into P divided by Kd plus Kad into P, equation number 4, dividing numerator and denominator by Kd, rate constant for desorption. We get theta is equal to Kad over Kd into P divided by Kd by Kd plus Kad by Kd into P, equation number 4. For the ratio of two constants, Kad over Kd, Kad over Kd, we can write K. Let us suppose that rate constant for adsorption, the ratio between rate constant for adsorption and rate constant for desorption is represented by K. And this K is called the adsorption coefficient. Making this substitution into equation 4, we get theta is equal to Kp divided by 1 plus Kp, equation number 5. Theta is the covered area of the adsorbent. Now, if we suppose that the amount of gas adsorbed per unit mass of adsorbent is represented by X, let us suppose that X, now we suppose that X is the amount of gas adsorbed per gram of adsorbent then we can write that this quantity X is directly proportional to theta. The amount of gas adsorbed per gram of adsorbent, X is directly proportional to theta. Putting the value of theta from equation 5 into equation 6, we get X is proportional to Kp divided by 1 plus Kp. To change proportionality into equality, we use another constant. X is equal to K dash Kp 1 plus Kp. Inverting both sides, we get 1 by X is equal to 1 over K dash 1 plus Kp divided by Kp. We have the equation 1 by X is equal to 1 over K dash 1 plus Kp and divided by Kp. We bring P to the other side and we get P by X is equal to 1 over K dash 1 plus Kp by K, or 1 over K dash 1 by K plus P, or we can write P by X 1 over K dash into K plus 1 over K dash into P, or P over X is equal to 1 over K dash into K plus P by K dash. K dash into K can be represented by K double dash, or we can write P over X is equal to 1 over K double dash plus P by K bar, equation number 6. Now here we have obtained Langmuir's adsorption equation in the form of a straight line equation. It is an equation of straight line. It is Langmuir's adsorption equation. P by X is equal to 1 over K dash over P by K dash. It relates quantities X and P, where X is the amount of gas adsorbed per gram of adsorbent and P is the applied pressure of gas on the surface of adsorbent. Now if we change the pressure, then the quantity P over X will also change. P over X is considered to be the dependent variable and P is independent variable. So when we change the pressure of gas at a given temperature above the solid surface, then P by X will also change. We keep a record of P and P over X, and then we plot a graph between P by X along ordinate and P along abscissa so that we get a straight line. we find out the values of P over X at a number of different pressures, and then we plot a graph between P over X along ordinate and the pressure P, gauge pressure along abscissa, so that we get a straight line. The intercept of the line is equal to 1 over k double dash. It is called the intercept. We had already discussed that in equation of straight line, if we plot a graph between P and P over X, then we get a straight line whose intercept is equal to 1 over k double dash, from where we can get the value of k double dash, and we find the angle theta, and we calculate the slope of the curve. Slope is equal to tangent theta, and it gives the value of 1 over k dash is equal to 1 over k dash. So from the intercept we can calculate the constant k dash. From the intercept we can calculate 1 over, intercept gives us 1 over k double dash, from which we can calculate the value of constant k double dash, and the slope is equal to tangent theta, and this slope gives the value of 1 over k dash, from which we can calculate k dash. It is okay for today. Allah Hafiz.